Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Rep. William Sam McCann is a Republican currently representing the 50th district in central Illinois. He turned heads when he announced he was running for governor as the nominee of the newly founded Conservative Party in April 2018. He is now turning heads for a very different reason, and it has many conservatives as well as many other residents of the city of Chicago cheering. McCann has filed a bill in an effort to redirect $180 million set aside in a grant by the state of Illinois for infrastructure surrounding the Obama Presidential Center. It is a grant the heavily indebted state can ill afford. McCann states it is not fair to the people residing downstate to see their already high taxes increase even further to pay for infrastructure improvements in the Chicagoland area that they may never see or receive any benefit from. The project has faced a significant amount of criticism even from those local to Chicago's south side. Professors and faculty members from the University of Chicago, where former President Barack Obama once taught, voiced significant objections as well. They, along with many neighborhood residents and activists, do not believe the Obama Center will deliver any sort of economic benefits to Chicago's south side. Other critics say that the use of government-owned land to build a private facility will hurt instead of help Chicago's south side neighborhood. Trending, McDonald's worker body slams female customer over a milkshake and free drink. We remain steadfast in our opposition to the confiscation of public parkland for the Obama Presidential Center, which is a private facility, Charles A. Birnbaum, president and CEO of the Cultural Landscape Foundation. Birnbaum added, the people of Chicago were told they would get a presidential library administered by the National Archives, a federal facility, in exchange for the confiscation of historic parkland, listed in the National Register of Historic Places. Instead, they're getting a privately operated entertainment campus with a 235-foot-tall tower, a recording studio, auditorium, and sports facility, and other amenities. The Obama Foundation has stated that the proposed site on designated historic parkland would not be administered by the National Archives and Records Administration and would not function as a presidential library housing records, manuscripts, and papers from the Obama White House, as is the norm. Instead, the proposed center would include a museum, a public plaza, a library, and an athletic center, essentially functioning as a community center for the privileged. This announcement has sparked significant questions of just how useful is a presidential library if there is nothing for scholars to research housed within it. According to the Chicago Tribune, the Obama Library seems more like a playland than a presidential archive. The facility will house a children's play garden, sledding hill, green spaces for picnics and outdoor gatherings, basketball courts, and even the recording studio. After months of deliberations and planning with the University of Chicago, the University of Hawaii, and New York City's Columbia University, all vying for the honor of hosting the Obama Library, in April 2015 the Obamas chose Chicago as the location for the facility. Yet many months later the University of Chicago is wondering if all they are actually getting is an overgrown community center. Other presidential libraries hold the full archives of its namesake's papers, and it is a place where scholars go to do deep and extensive research in an effort to discover what happened during a president's time in office as well as the life prior to the White House. Many of Obama's classified documents are still in the hands of the federal government in Washington, D.C., but the remainder of his records are currently located in a suburban storage facility near Chicago. Without these papers and archives, exactly what use will Obama's library be for the city of Chicago? Why would the state grant land, reduce the city's green space in a historic parkland, forego future profits from the parking garage, and force the entirety of the already overburdened tax-paying populace of the state of Illinois to pay for it? These are the questions McCann is asking, and he states it is the exact reason for the bill's proposal. In a statement, McCann announced that he filed legislation to reverse the $180 million appropriation on grounds that there are better uses for the money than dropping it on a high-profile luxury project. I am calling on my fellow legislators to join me in making the fiscally responsible decision to put this $180 million back in our road fund, McCann said. Illinois hasn't had a comprehensive capital bill since 2010, and the American Society of Civil Engineers gave our roads a D grade last year. If we cannot provide central and southern Illinois with safe and efficient roads, we cannot afford to pump money into high-profile luxury projects. citizens in central and southern Illinois counting on us to make sure that their tax dollars make a positive difference in their lives, and that is what this bill will do, McCann added. It also sends an important message that we will support economic development efforts throughout the entire state. There has also been significant pushback from within the Hyde Park community, yet critics are attempting to silence these criticisms with cries of racism, class, segregation, and so-called privilege. The Chicago Tribune reports, the Obama Foundation's plans to build the Obama Presidential Center in Jackson Park have sparked a complicated, and at times emotional, conversation about race, class, segregation, privilege and power on the South Side. The conversation has raised delicate and fragile issues. Who gets a voice in the discussion? Who gets heard? Who gets action? And how the history of racial and class segregation shapes expectations. There are those who see the development as an opportunity for a long-time homeowners to finally get investment and an increase in property values. Others worry that rising rents will push out poor African Americans. They fear development will cater to elite, highly educated blacks while working-class families lose access to lakefront communities. Residents who are pushing for a community benefits agreement, CBA, a contract guaranteeing property tax freezes and jobs, have been told they should find entrepreneurial ways to benefit from the coming attraction. Meanwhile, white Hyde Park residents have been accused of being silent about displacement, affordable housing and unemployment, while using their voices to save birds, butterflies and nature sanctuaries, or to object to longer commute times. And when black residents have voiced their desire to preserve park and green space, they have been told that with all the inequities African Americans have to deal with, parkland should be the least of their worries. In some ways, it's the collision of issues facing the entire city, but playing out dramatically in four neighborhoods: Hyde Park, Washington Park, South Shore and Woodlawn. The center will cost more than $300 million to build and is expected to bring hundreds of jobs and visitors that could ultimately transform the South Side. Yet what that will mean varies among the different constituencies that share the neighborhood. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.